Hi Libra, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and today we'll be doing your February read. Let's see what energies are flowing towards you in February 2022, Libra. And of course, these are general collective readings, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you and leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Libra and send them the messages they need to hear the most for February. Thank you. All right, Libra, let's start your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you. Thank you for being here. And Libra, if you're new here, do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. All right, Libra. Oh my God, the Emperor. I'll just show you one second. Okay, Libra. Libra, Libra, Libra. And secret message from the universe. Bottom of my deck, I have the Sun card for you, Libra. Wow. This is the happiest card in the deck. Happiest card in the deck as your overall energy for February 2022. Let's see what's happening here. Okay, so Libra, you are trying to see things from a higher perspective right now. You are fighting for something. You are fighting for something, and well, maybe other people are in your business or something. I don't know what this is. I'm going to clarify it. But in the recent past, well, there is some awakening that happened, something which you wanted to re-begin or restart. You are not listening to anyone, it seems. I think you've decided, I'm going to see, take the higher ground now. I'm going to see things from my own perspective now. Whatever you're doing here, Libra, this is your current energy. It's taking you straight into February and sitting on your throne as the Emperor. Now look at this person. His wand is higher than the others. There are lots of people trying to maybe, you know, give advice or fight or argue or give whatever suggestions. But one person says, hey, no, I'm going to listen to myself now. And this kind of attitude of yours, there's some major change that's happened in the recent past in your life, Libra. I don't know what that is, but it's taking you straight to being in control of your own life in Feb. So what I'm going to do, Libra, before I start clarifying these cards, I'm going to take a Ganesha oracle card for you. Let's see what Lord Ganesha has for you as a blessing for the month of February. And then we'll, of course, go on with the reading. So Lord Ganesha, for my Libra gang, please, what blessing do you have for them for February? For Libra? Blessing for Libra from Lord Ganesha. Okay, this one. Okay. All right, so let's take this one. And the card says, generosity. I think Libra, it's time to, well, if he's going to be sitting on the Emperor's chair, make sure, of course, very good to be generous to others, but be generous to yourself as well. I don't know. Let's see what Ganesha has to say to this card. I'm going to read a few lines for you, Libra, from this. Let's put this card here so you can see it. It's a beautiful card of, what is it? Oh, Lord Ganesha is offering sweetmeats to the little mouse. Generosity. Let's see. Where's the book? Okay, here it is. And the number is number 10. Number 10. I'm sure there's a message here for you, which is more profound than I can explain it. So let's read a couple of lines. Generosity. Compassion for others is a natural result of being aware and conscious of your own feelings. When you are generous in spirit, you take complete responsibility for your life. Work with Ganesha to assist you with stepping up to do the right thing. This is especially important when you are filled with fear and conflicting feelings. Respect others and live a conscious life. Champion others, support them, and actively want them to succeed. Living from this space will create an open heart and mind that will touch anyone who comes into your presence. Be tolerant of ideas and behaviors that may not align with your own thoughts. Spend more time looking at what is good and positive in someone else rather than what you judge as negative or bad. Embrace others' differences. Give freely and from your heart. Choose to no longer manipulate and do not do favors with strings attached. As you continue to give, you may find that you no longer envy others. You are able to give easily and at the same time receive when the same is offered to you. This will go a long way of eliminating the feeling of being separated from others, and you may find yourself feeling genuinely happy. Look for and assume the best in people and treat others with respect and acceptance. So what Lord Ganesha is basically saying, I mean, of course you understood, but what this is what I'm getting out of it, that, you know, start, when you open your heart out to others, instead of feeling, oh, what if I give them and they don't give me back, and what if, oh, you know, just give freely. Be in that loving, open space and see how the universe responds, how others will start responding to you as well, in the same way. Okay, so let's take one from our angels as well. Let's see what our angels have. My angels, what do you have for Libra for February? Speak your truth. Speak your truth from your heart. Be open-hearted. Don't keep things in your heart. No envy, no jealousy, no feeling that others may not want to give to you. Just you do the right thing from your end. What does an emperor do? An emperor sits on their throne and they are very just and they're very kind and they're very, you know, they have a large heart, I would say. An emperor rules his kingdom with fairness and equality and generosity. So, well, there is happiness coming from you, for you, with the Sun card as our overall energy. But let's see what the reading has to say. Seven of Wands spirit for their Libra's current energy. Libra, if you've been feeling lack, if you've been feeling that you are short on money or resources or just feeling out in the cold right now, well, I think it's time now to stop bothering about what people are saying. Stop listening to too many opinions. I think it's time to pursue something that puts you into that childlike, adventurous spirit. Okay, because once you start listening to your own guidance, it's taking you straight to a beautiful place of harmony, peace, abundance, and stability. What happened to Libra? What in the recent past, spirit? What's his judgment card? What's the judgment card? I think you had a little bit of difficulty in opening up in the past. The King of Cups came out, but came out reversed. Even though the cards were upright, this one just flipped and flipped, in reverse. So I'll read it as that. Maybe in the past you were a bit closed off or feeling unloved or feeling in lack and feeling the lack of support from others. But something has happened here, Libra. Maybe a change of perspective. Maybe you changed. And you started or are thinking of, this is what you want. This is what you want. You want emotional happiness. You want happiness with others. You want to celebrate life. And well, you are dreaming of, or you have been in the recent past of having this. Of having this rebirth and a beautiful, harmonious life with others. Okay. Well, you're heading straight to it from what I see. So what's coming up for Libra spirit in February? What's the Emperor? What's the Emperor for Libra? Some wishes of yours are going to come true. Well, you're going in the right direction. You are taking your guidance, aren't you? I think you are saying no to naysayers now. You're not letting other people influence you to what your heart really wants. Because when you're guided by your own soul, your own heart, your angels, spirit guides, you really can't go wrong, Libra. Follow your bliss. And I have a feeling you'll be doing that in February because I get the Star card. Now you had the Sun card, Star card and the Emperor for the February energy. What else for February, spirit? What else for Feb? You're going to make a sudden decision. Sudden change, sudden decision. Okay, so generosity. See, this is how you've been feeling, right? Feeling, oh my God, nothing ever works out for me. Feeling the lack, feeling, you know, maybe lack of money, feeling lack of, you know, have to hold on. I can't, I don't have, you know, this lack miser kind of a mentality that one gets in when you're feeling down and out. Maybe you've been feeling that. There's going to be a sudden change in February. It's going to feel like a tower moment. I don't know how this is going to happen. It's maybe some swift action that you take for yourself, which pushes you forward. The energy is going to change to such a degree that you'll have a clear sight ahead and lead straight to a beautiful energy of give and take. See, from lack, it's like that tower that suddenly erupts, and then there's clarity, and then you're heading straight towards equal give and take. There is a flow of energies, there is generosity, what you give is what you get, you know, that kind of a feeling. And that's how you feel on top of the world, feeling like an emperor. So what should Libra hold on to, Spirit? What should Libra hold on to? Spirit says, well, tell Libra, I've already told them, the star is waiting for them. Some wishes of theirs are going to come true. So don't give up on this wish. Whatever you've been wishing for is going to happen, Libra. But the choice is yours. Choice is yours. Stop going back and forth in your mind. You'll have to be very concise and precise about your manifestations, like the King of Swords, right? Very clear-headed, one direction and one direction only. I'm not going to look left, right, anywhere. I know where I'm going and what I want. So Spirit says, all the choice is yours. You can keep yourself in balance for as long as you want to, keep going back and forth. But what we would recommend, hold on to this dream of yours. It's going to come true once you make that decision, once you make that choice. So what should Libra let go of, Spirit? Hermit. Why should Libra let go? Okay. Libra, what's happening is... Okay. What's happening is, Libra, there is something that makes your heart sing, right? Something that you've been patiently waiting for, something that you want to move towards with all your passion, or everything that inside you, you've been wanting to go towards it. I think Spirit is saying it's time to take that action. Instead of waiting around, waiting for the right time, right? This angel is pouring one cup into the other and then one into the other. This is like that back and forth energy again. What Spirit is saying, we need to get you out of this hermit mode now. Right? You can't keep yourself isolated for the rest of your life, Libra, thinking, should I not? Right? Libras do have a little bit of trouble trying to make decisions. But in February, Spirit is promising you, get out of your head, first of all. Get out of your head. Stop overthinking it. Stop spending so much time going back and forth. Start to take action. Start to take action. And then see the beauty of everything that's going to flow in. This, by doing this, you're actually doing yourself a favor, because that's taking you straight to self-love. Do something that really makes you happy. Ask your heart, ask your soul, what gives me this feeling of sunshine, of happiness, of joy? And then stop thinking about it. Just do it. Your great energy is coming. The energy is available, Libra, but we have free will as well, right? You can, I mean, the doorbell can ring. I may choose to get up and open the door or not. It's my decision. But there could be a big gift somebody's brought for me and is waiting at the door and ringing the doorbell and I'm not opening the door. Okay, so what can become Libra's biggest blockage, Spirit, in February? The Knight of Pentacles, taking no action. Look at this knight. When is this knight ever going to reach his destination, sitting on a horse which is not moving even one leg in front of the other, not even trotting or crawling or anything? This should be galloping by now, right? This knight has been waiting patiently for a very long time, but there's no movement. And if this is you, Libra, in stagnant energy, well, that this is what can become your blockage. Why will the Knight of Pentacles become a blockage, Spirit, for Libra? Yeah, because you feel, well, I'm sitting here with my broken heart. I'm by myself. I have everything that I need. Do I really want to go and see what else is out there? This is a little bit of a pity party, I would say. Even though, yes, you may be very comfortable where you are, in your own singlehood or in your space or your home, or you feel, oh, well, I have enough food to eat and I have good clothes to wear, and I really want to, you know, I've been heartbroken so many times, so I should maybe just shut the gate of my castle and sit here and mope for the rest of my life and not make a move. Well, your ships are waiting. Like I just said, somebody could be waiting outside the door with a gift for me, and what if I don't move? Your ships are coming in. So don't just stand there, take action, go receive it. So how will people be seeing my Libra gang spirit in the month of February? Page of Swords. Why is that? Oh, wow. That's good. That's wonderful. Okay, Libra, I think you're going to take this advice. I have a feeling you're going to take that advice. People are going to be spying on you. They're going to be watching you. Maybe they've been trying to give you advice which you don't want to take, because maybe you're dealing with a lot of naysayers, right? But even if you tell them that I don't want your advice, they'll still be spying to see what is Libra going to do next. Where are they going? What are they doing? They're going to be seeing you taking huge strides. This is Ace of Pentacles, Ace of Swords. Absolutely clear-minded, focus into a beautiful new beginning, new journey with stability, happiness, and looking great while doing it as well, shining bright. This is how people are going to be seeing you, and they'll be spying on you to say, what is Libra up to? Why are they looking so good? Why are they looking so happy? Why are they shining this bright? Where, how did this ever happen for them? Why? Because Libra took action. They were being guided. The sun is shining. The stars are making their wishes come true in February. And my Libra, at least my gang, is now going to say, enough of this back and forth. I am going to go towards something which is going to make me happy. And there'll be a lot of people watching you and wondering, really? You took this leap of faith? You cleared your own path? And look at you shining. I'm so proud that I keep showing you these cards. Anyway, Libra, I'm going to open this card, which is our secret message from the universe. Let's see what my spirit world has to as a secret advice or a message for you. Three of Wands in reverse. Yes, stop waiting. Your ships are coming in. This card came out earlier as well when I said, you know, you can't keep waiting forever. Spirit is saying the end of waiting in Feb. Why is the Three of Wands in reverse, Spirit? Three of Wands in reverse. You're taking control. This card has come out again. I told you this is the February energy for you. You're taking control of your own life, Libra. The energy has arrived to put you in your element, on your throne. One more for the Three of Wands. Emperor, King of Pentacles, and end of stagnation. You're going to start moving now, and the more action you're going to take now, Libra, is going to put you into a very secure and stable place for you. Okay, so make sure this waiting is over. That's the only hitch I see in this reading, the only hindrance, and there could be maybe other people. It's called the crab mentality. Do you know? I hope you know the story of the crab mentality, right? You put, say, 10 crabs in an open basket, and one crab, the strong one, tries to climb out of the basket. There's no lid on it, right? So one is almost out, and the ones which are left down hold the top one's leg and pull it down. People don't like to see other people progress sometimes, which is sad. I feel you're going through something like that, and that's the reason you keep going back and forth, because there are naysayers around you. So what's the Sun card going to bring for my Libra spirit in February? What's the Sun card for Libra? Okay, wonderful. It's the ending of the cycle. Ending of this heavy burden that you've been carrying, Libra. You can end it now. At least start thinking about it. We still have a few days to go. In February, this heavy load that you've been carrying, maybe it's just opinions of others, or maybe overwork or overexertion. Whatever you've been doing, I think you have to end this chapter down. Maybe you've been working very hard. You've been maybe spending too much time with your head down and doing nothing else, but maybe single-handedly being that Nine of Pentacles person saying, hey, me by myself, you know, I just keep myself safe and secure. Well, Spirit is saying, stop. It's time now to move. It's time now to take action, because the minute you take action, the energies are going to open up and take you straight to a place of abundance. It's going to transform your life. And you know how it's going to transform your life, Libra? Ace of Wands, action. This action is going to propel you into this brand new journey full of abundance and happiness. I told you the 10 wands have to be dropped now. Where did they go? Did I drop them, Spirit? Where are those 10 wands gone? Yeah, here. You drop all these 9 wands and just keep that one and start again. Don't think too hard. This is the ending of an old cycle, old way of doing things, Libra. Okay, so that's all I have for you. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste, Libra. And don't forget to take action.